Hello. Today we're going to talk about ego or the big snooze. Bear with me, it's going to make sense shortly. When I first started getting into self-helpery, there was a lot of talk about something called ego. That confused the hell out of me because I always thought the ego was being conceited or braggy. But even though arrogance and conceit are part of ego, what I've learned is they're not all of it. In the self-help spiritual community, ego is used to refer to the shallow self or the false self. It's the part of us that is driving the bus when we do things like sabotage our own happiness. So in other words, there's more than one way to go on an ego trip. I'm going to refer to the ego as the big snooze, or BS for short. I think it's less confusing, plus I think it's more appropriate since the leading cause of us sucking is because we haven't woke up yet to how truly powerful we are and how massively abundant our universe is. The big snooze operates according to your limiting beliefs. This is the garbage that was stuffed into your subconscious as a little kid that doesn't ring true for you, as well as the decisions you've made about yourself that are less than flattering or empowering. The big snooze lives in the past and it lives in the future. And it believes that you are separate from everything around you. Your true self or higher self, your non-BS self, on the other hand, is the part of you that operates according to your connection with your source energy. We all experience life in varying degrees from both perspectives, and while I seriously doubt that there's anyone that's totally snooze-free, most people are so wrapped up in the BS that they're settling for a reality that's way beneath what is available to them. Very few people are even aware of what's available because we live in a fear-based society that loves to get all uppity towards people who wake up and blast out of their comfort zone to follow their great unknown. Often taking leaps of faith is labeled as irresponsible or selfish. Until you succeed, of course, then you're brilliant. Because watching somebody else totally go for it can be incredibly upsetting to the person who spent a lifetime building a solid case for why they can't do it. I'm obviously generalizing people, and there will be people that cheer you on. But you must be prepared that when you wake up and start massive action to change your life, there will be disapproval from other people who are snoring away, especially some of the people closest to you. As bad as it sounds, it's true. Hey, Shirley, are you going to quit your corporate job here to open up that nail salon? You have 2 kids, a mortgage, and high blood pressure. You know, most new businesses don't succeed. Aren't you worried about what will happen to your family if you fail? Of course Shirley's worried about what will happen to her family if she fails. She panics about it all the time. But what she's done is she's moved past her fear to create something she's really psyched about. Even though people may be saying these things out of love and concern, having others smear their fear and worry all over you is the last thing you need when you're strengthening your superhero muscle to step out and take some risks. So I suggest that you don't even talk to these people about this. Surround yourself with people that bring you up, not bring you down. Seek out people that are already kicking ass. Surround yourself with good, with happy, with people that believe. You're going to do enough internal fighting and battles throughout this journey. BS is like an overprotective Italian mother that not only doesn't ever want you to go outside, she doesn't ever want you to leave her house. Her intentions are good, but fully fear-based. As long as you stay inside the familiar risk-free zone and present in your reality, BS is content. But should you try to sneak past her and approach your new life, she's going to hurl her body in front of you. Basically, she's going to do whatever she can to stop you. And it ain't going to be pretty. Kind of like when you quit smoking or doing drugs. You go into withdrawal. You finally take the leap and did something that's going to massively improve your life, but for a long time, you're going to feel worse than you did. Hacking out all the nasty crap, ridding your body of toxins, shaking, sweating, puking, wondering why on earth you thought that this was a good idea. The same goes for when you rid yourself of your limiting subconscious beliefs that have been holding you back and that have, and that now that we've taken our giant leap outside of our comfort zone, it's like a detox. And sometimes it can feel like the universe is conspiring against us. When in reality, the BS is creating chaos in an attempt to self-sabotage and keep everything as is instead of moving forward into the unknown. Every successful person knows this and has been through this. When taking leaps forward, life often turns to shit before shinola. Remember, you create your reality. You have spent a lifetime creating the one that you presently have and is largely based on your limiting beliefs. When you decide to rewire those beliefs and go for what is in your heart and do a massive overhaul of yourself in your world, you're basically murdering the BS. It's going to come at you, rolling pin raised over her head to beat you back into your old life. We are very powerful creatures who create our own reality through force energy. And should our subconscious mind decide to focus that energy at stopping us from taking a risk because it's freaking out and terrified, things can get a little crazy. The BS will do everything it can to stop you from changing and growing. Because you're attempting to get rid of the very identity that you and everyone else has come to know of you. Never underestimate the power of BS, scorned. It will set up emotional blocks and try to stop you. So if you decide to quit your goal-crushing job and start the pastry shop of your dreams, don't be upset if a truck drives through the front window right into your scones. Instead of taking that as a sign that you shouldn't have opened your shop, take it to mean that you're ridding yourself of the BS and moving in the right direction. Growth is not for wimps, guys, but it's nowhere near as painful as living the life you are living now if you are not really going for it. If you want to take control of your life and turn into the spectacular you that you are, have faith. Trust that your new life is already here and it's far better than the old one. Hang tight. If BS pitches a fit, whatever happens, stay the course because there's nothing better than watching your entire reality shift into one that is a perfect expression of you.